Okay, this instruction video is for the new Flashbang series of holsters designed for ladies where nothing comes between a girl and her gun. The Flashbang holster is designed to be worn presumably by women. The holster simply attaches to the bra band right here in the middle via this little strap, which will snap in place around the center of the bra band. You will notice that there's some texturing material here. That portion of the holster will ride within the band, actually up inside underneath the underwire portion of the cup. And for a right-handed shooter, it would be riding right about there. The breast tissue would actually ride against the back of the holster, pressing the texturing against the front of the bra, which helps keep the muzzle from dropping down. The screw that attaches the strap also can be tensioned at different angles. I've kind of loosened it a little bit so you can see that it will rotate. With the strap on the top, it allows the holster to sit down a little further, allowing the grip of the pistol to ride just below the sternum or the breastbone. If you want the pistol grip to ride higher, you can loosen the screw and simply rotate, and then you can snap it this direction and it will ride higher in the bra band with the muzzle pointing more downhill. The grip sets up a little higher, and then depending upon your build, it could make the grip a little more difficult to reach. However, it also makes it a lot more comfortable when sitting if you have any kind of a tummy at all. That way the grip doesn't poke your upper abdomen. Now the holster, people I know that have been wearing this holster find it easier simply to just disconnect from the bra and take it off so that you can access the opening. You'll see on the bottom where the grip sticks out that there's an opening on the holster. Okay, that is where I tell people to insert the muzzle of the pistol. By getting into the widest portion with the narrow part of the muzzle, they can split this clamshell apart as they insert. It will simply spread out. Notice there are no sharp edges or protrusions which can catch the trigger while inserting the pistol. One of the biggest flaws in some of the older holsters is thumb straps and such that would get inside the trigger and actually pull the trigger while the weapon is being holstered. Start the muzzle of the pistol inside the wide gap. You see right there, it just slips right in. And as I begin, I'm going to go slowly so you can hopefully see what's going on here. The clamshell splits open. And it's kind of awkward when I go this slow. It splits it open, and once everything lines up with where the molding is, you'll notice the clamshell will just close around the gun, just like that. It just basically snaps in place. Okay, I'm going to turn it from different angles so you can see. Okay. Notice the trigger guard is completely covered. It is impossible to pull the trigger while it's in the holster. Okay, so once the weapon is inside this holster, there's no danger of the trigger being pulled. And so the direction of the muzzle, for those of you who have concerns about covering body parts, is not as much of a problem because the trigger cannot be pulled in this position. Okay. To install it, you simply run the strap around, snap it, okay, and then you position the holster up inside. Now realize this is a hard plastic mannequin, and it's not quite as flexible, but it's the only girlfriend my wife would let me use, so okay. The muzzle can be adjusted up and down. On a regular person, it's going to sit about like that. You can adjust this strap, like I said before. You see where the grip is hanging down quite a ways. You can adjust the strap the other direction, and it will ride higher. Snap it all the way. That's that. There we go. And it will, because of the hard plastic breast, it's not going to go up as high, but you can see that less grip is showing. And so if you're a lady who has a little bit of a tummy, riding like that would be easier when you're sitting. that way much more comfortably. The manufacturer of the holster is currently about 8.5 months pregnant, and that's how she carries her revolver, is in the upwardmost position. You can still access the grip and get the gun out. Okay, it's pretty easy to do. I'm going to snap it here. Phillips screwdriver, standard screwdriver. Tighten that screw down. I always put my finger on the back to make sure it's not spinning. You don't need a death grip, it just needs to be snug. Now then, I'm going to reinstall the pistol. I'm going slow again so you can see what I'm doing. It just closes around it. These snaps are directional, so they will only snap one direction. What that means is if you wear it in the other position, in the down position where the grip is higher, you don't have to worry about the bra strap unhooking the snap when you pull. Now, there are concerns that people who have watched the original video thought that somehow the gun was going to shoot her in the face. As you can see, the muzzle is pointing away from the body. The muzzle is right here. The edge of the breast is right here. It's under the breast, pointing away from the body. Now, if the person is walking, their arm will move in front of the holster move in front of the muzzle while it's in the holster, but as you see with the trigger guard being covered, there's no way for this firearm to fire. When you draw the pistol, most bras have elastic straps which will give and will stretch. Okay, you can tighten and loosen these straps. I'm going to move this closer. But when the person draws and they should theoretically pull their shirt up high enough that their left elbow will come up out of the way of the gun as it's being drawn. But as the firearm is being drawn, the bra is going to stretch down because of the shoulder straps. Okay, it is now out from underneath the bra here because I went so slow. But if I go in slow motion, it's going to pull and pull until finally the force overcomes the force of the clamshell. Okay, realize I don't have a proper grip on this firearm, and that's why it kind of came loose a little bit. So we will reinstall, and I just flashed you with my plastic girlfriend. Reinstall. But realize that as the shoulder straps stretch, I was down about belly button level before the clamshell released and the gun was free. Okay, if you pull the shirt up to chest level, pull the gun down, the bra is going to stretch, the gun comes free about belly button level, and it's a matter of rotating your arm out, pointing the gun in extreme close quarter situations, and firing the shot from the waist if they're close enough that you cannot extend your arms out and aim and fire an aim shot. If they're in your face in touching distance, it is easy to fire from the hip, what they call a one-hand tactical position at the police academy, and fire into the guy's chest area or abdomen area, torso area, and get the person out of your face. And as you create distance, then you can step back, put both hands on the firearm, and fire more accurate aim shots if needed. This is a semi-automatic pistol, which I prefer over the 38. Number one, because of capacity, it holds 6 shots in the magazine plus 1 shot in the chamber for a total of 7 rounds. Your typical revolver that's concealable are 5 shot revolvers. As you can see, this weapon is not loaded. Okay. Most 5 shot revolvers are much wider than semi-autos are. Okay. If you're a larger person, it is not a problem to hide a revolver. This one happens to be a Ruger LCR lightweight compact revolver. This is a brand new out of the box revolver. This holster is custom molded for the Ruger. Again, you'll see the opening, which is perfect for starting the muzzle, and you can actually twist the pistol and get it into that clamshell. I'm going slow again, and as I work it into place, it just closes around it once it's lined up. It will not close unless everything is lined up. Again, the trigger cannot be pulled while it's in the holster. You see the same texturing for the muzzle. This is also a right-handed holster. This model has the new directional snap. It's a little harder to manipulate, which I like, because once it's there, it's not going anywhere. The bottom edge has to be started in first, so you tilt it, and once that's lipped, it just snaps over, and it's not going to go anywhere. I'm going to shake. I'm shaking pretty hard. I've never done that with this gun or this holster, so I'm holding my hand because I don't want to drop a brand new gun. As you can see, it's pretty sturdy. It's not bouncing out. You know, I guess if she wanted to jump on a trampoline or something, she may have to be concerned, but everyday movement, walking, you know, running or whatever, she shouldn't have a problem with this popping out of the holster. The weapon should be secured. Okay, I'm going to set this one in here. Again, the mannequin is very unforgiving. Right in the audience, this one's not going to, just simply isn't going to ride straight. It's sagging down. But the muzzle is right there. The edge of the breast is right there. The muzzle is pointing away from the body. And again, during the draw, let me better hold it. Let's see if I can hold this back strap so it doesn't slide as far. There we go. And it's just a matter of clearing. And we're out. Okay. Now let's talk a little bit about, I don't know, for lack of a better word, I'm going to call it momentum. If you're pulling away from resistance, okay, you're using your muscles to pull on an object, and you suddenly lose the resistance, your hand is going to quickly move away from the resistance. So the concerns that some people have had about somehow reversing that momentum and pointing the gun at themselves during a draw goes against physics, basically. Okay. Once the resistance of the clamshell is released, the weapon quickly moves away from the holster, down and out, away from the body. It's a matter of just tilting the elbow in and rotating and firing shots if you're shooting from the hip or coming up into a shooting position and using aimed fire for more distant targets. Once again, this is the Flashbang holster.